Right. Now let's come back and do solve this numerical. What do they give us? Calculate the potential of the half cell containing 0.1 molar of potassium dichromate, 0.2 molar of KCr plus 3, is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 4 molar of H plus ions. And they've given us one reaction. Now, what formula should I apply? Now, in this particular thing, they've given us what to calculate potential, cell potential. That means I have to calculate E cell. Right. And one more thing, you should be clear what formula should you apply, I said, right? So first let us write the Nernst equation, because from the Nernst equation only you can calculate E cell, 0.059 divided by N, yeah, log products by reactants. Now important, what type of reaction did they give us? They've not given us any cell half cell reaction, no cell rotation. They've directly given you the complete reaction, that is, it has reached an equilibrium state. See here, they've given you a balanced reaction. That means after transaction of 6 electrons, they've given you a balanced reaction. That means the reaction has reached an equilibrium state. So when the reaction has reached an equilibrium state, what is the formula we write? We write E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 by N log KC. This is what is the formula. Because seeing this, I understood that it has come to equilibrium. Now what is KC equal to? KC, it is equal to products by reactants. Done. Now what is the product here? Observe carefully. In this particular reaction, done, you have two things. One is chromium plus 3 ion as well as H plus ion. Now start. Now we very well know, first you have to start with the oxidation state. This is the oxidized oxidation reaction and this is a reduction reaction. Now start with chromium. This is the first oxidation reaction, that is Cr plus 3 product by reactant, that is Cr2O7 minus 2. Done. Now this is raised to the power 2. This is raised. Okay. There is nothing else. There is no coefficient. Now second comes your water. H2O raised to the power of 7 divided by H plus, which is raised to the power of 14. Now come back and substitute. What is Cr plus 3 given? How much is the concentration? 0.2. Okay, let's write that. That's 0.2. Raised to the power of 2 coefficient. How much is water? Water is 1 always, isn't it? 1 divided by Cr2O7. How much do they give us? 0.1 into H plus. How much is H plus given to us? 1 into 10 to the power of minus 4 raised to the power of 14. 14. Done. Now what are we going to do? We are going to now solve this whole thing. When you solve this whole thing, you get an answer of 0.4 into 10 raised to the power of 56. Now still I'm not done. Why am I not done? Because I have to find out log KC value. So log KC, if I have to find out for this 0.4 and 10 was 56, first you find out for log 4, you'll get the value, then multiply with that. So when I find the log value, I get an answer of 55.6. now substitute this whole thing in this formula. Hope you have understood why did I take this formula here. Done. So E cell is equal to E naught cell. How much is given to us? 1.33 minus 0.059 N. How many electrons have transacted? 6 electrons into 55.6. And finally, when I solve this whole concept, the whole answer, I get an answer of 0.78 volts. So hopefully, right, you'll put a box like this and write E cell is equal to 0.78 volts. That is your potential of the given cell, of potential of the given reaction.